Hey, hi, hello everyone, and welcome to another Long War 2 tutorial. I'm Falek, and today we are going to be talking about base management. I know I said we were going to do ambushes, but when I was sitting to it, I thought that it's pretty silly to do it with only rookies, and I finished the Gatecrasher mission, so we can do the ambushes with some actual soldiers, so I can show you how things actually may be done, right? And since we are in the base, we are going to talk about the base management first, because it's on the way, right? So, the base tab management that I personally use and prefer has some special kinks to it that basically are made to utilize the engineers to the best possible efficiency rather than to get yourself going as fast as possible. And there are a lot of variables that I will be mentioning during the recording, so I'm gonna try to make it as uncomplicated as possible, because I have tendency to make stupid and derailed sentences like this one. In any case, when you start your base, if you got an empty space on the left, on the right, you're lucky. If you are having a space on the, in the middle, then that's a little worse, but it's still manageable. It depends how fast do you want your guerrilla tactics school and AWC. I personally am not that much in a hurry to them, so I am okay with delaying them a little bit if I get a middle space empty at the start of the game, because I like to put my resistance communications or a power plant in here. And this is why. Right below it, right here, this is the centerpiece of the base. It's where I build a workshop. Workshop basically allows you to station engineers in there and send two gremlins to each of the rooms on the sides or above and below that basically pretend to be engineers and do their work for them. So that's why I want the stop space to be clear at the start of the game, so I can build the power relay over here. That's going to basically allow me to put an engineer in the workshop and have two people working in the power relay right off the bat after upgrades. And that is making everything much smoother expansion wise and allows me to build faster. So on the left or the right we build the guerrilla tactics school and the AWC. Now, which one comes first depends on your preferences. If you want to have officers and squad upgrades fast, then I recommend Guerrilla Tactics School, especially if you're not using the Commander's Choice mode, which I do. So I prefer to build the AWC, because it allows you to train the additional Advanced Warfare Center skills and makes your soldier heal their wounds faster, if you put a scientist in there even faster. And that is very important early in the game, where we don't have that much protective gear, soldiers are not that experienced, and wounds are easy and very easy to come by. So having soldiers back into the game faster allows them to get more experience and thus get less wounded later in the game. And the guerrilla tactics school is going to follow right after, as soon as the other debris field is cut down and we have supplies to build it, right? Now, as for the sides, one of them, if this is the your power relay, then one of the sides is going to be the resistance communications, and the other I recommend to be a proving ground facility, which is where also you can stock an engineer so that he can make projects for you and make them fast. Now, the only exception to that is if you get a lot of scientists early, because if you build a laboratory on one of the sides instead, then you can basically speed up your research to an extent that is going to give you a huge head start in the game. For even without rushing specific technologies, you can get ahead of the curve if you do that. However, if you don't get three to four scientists at the start of the game, then I suggest waiting until you dig up this place. Of course, we are digging every single room as soon as it is humanly possible, which the workshop will also help you with, because gremlins can dig. So I don't think I have to mention that. And in any case, the bottom field is going to be the additional power relay, unless it's an exposed coil, Well, actually, even if it's an exposed coil, an additional power relay is the best thing to build over here. And thus we have room for additional resistance communications right next to it. I know they're not getting adjacency bonuses, but it's okay. Really, it is. And with that we have the complete bottom run for our Psylab, for our turret facility, for our Shadow Ops, and whatever we need later in the game. Now, the only exceptions to that are, as I said, if you are getting a lot of scientists early, you want to build a laboratory so that your technologies get built faster, because it gives you a huge advantage, and if you are running Psy's, then you want to build Psylab in one of the upper corners rather than the complete bottom. So it basically depends on whether or not you are rushing specific technologies or not. And that's basically the very basic base layout that we want to be getting to. And with it, basically, you have your whole base game set up and easy, with your engineers working for the full amount of their weight and then some. And it's going to be also helpful in later game when you have those four little gremlins or more running around and doing your bidding. You have additional engineers to station in your liberated regions to give you more supplies, which is important, right? Now, as for upgrades, there are some buildings that you want to upgrade ASAP and some that are not necessary. Like, for example, I don't think it is super necessary to spend additional supplies on upgrading the AWC. While upgrading the guerrilla tactics school to train officers right off the bat is super mandatory. However, the second upgrade to build even more officers faster, I think, can wait when you have some spare resources and is not a priority. Same goes to your power stations and resistance comms. If you have enough resistance communications to move around faster and expand fluently, then you don't require upgrades. If you are starting to lack in the capacity, rather than building the next station, try upgrading it first and maybe it will do for you. You don't have to contact every single region in the game to win. Of course it helps, so I usually build two resistance comms, fully upgrade them, and then just with some luck it is sufficient. As for the power relays, you build them when you have to and upgrade them before building the next one. And remember that if you build a building on an exposed power coil, it's not going to cost you any money. It's not going to cost you any power to manage it. So if you want to build expensive buildings like the Shadow Ops, then exposed power coil is the place to be put. So that you don't actually have to build additionally a power relay to support them, right? And yeah, that's it for the basic base management. I hope you guys find this video useful. If so, let me know in the comments, like it, follow me on Facebook and Twitter and so on and so forth, and subscribe to the channel if you wanna. If you have any questions, also let me know in the comments. I'll be happy to reply as best as I can. And for now, thank you guys for watching. I've been Falek. See you later.